हेलो नमस्कार, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, एंड थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर स्टेइंग ट्यून टू हैशलर्न। हाउ आर यू, कैसे हो, कैमोन आचो, केम छो, हेगिदीरा बाउरनावा, वट एवर इट इज, द क्वेश्चन इज हाउ आर यू, एंड आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल विथ गॉड्स ग्रेस, एंड अ वेरी वार्म गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल दोज हु आर गोइंग टू जॉइन मी लेटर, राइट। एंड द रूल्स ऑफ द क्लास रिमेन्स द सेम, दैट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कनेक्ट टू मी you can come on our web page and you can connect with me via the comment section on the web page. Just in case you are watching this on YouTube, please do come on our web page. Now, as on your screen you can already see the law is flashed, that is law of independent assortment, that is the topic for today's class. So before we move into law of independent assortment, let's quickly see what we have discussed so far. So we have discussed till law of independent assortment, law of segregation, so law of not law of independent, law of dominance. The pehla law tha, that was law of dominance, in which in heterozygote, which states that in heterozygotic condition the gene which expresses itself in the phenotype is the dominant and the gene which fails to express itself is the recessive one. Then segregation, law of segregation simply says that during the time of gamete formation the genes will segregate though they were present throughout their life together, so there is no mixing of the genes. And good evening Ananya, Vikas, Aditya, very good evening. Is this your first class, Vikas? And hello Kirupakar, I hope I read your name correctly, pronounce your name right. And then we were into deviations. So deviations may we have discussed till the deviation from simple Mendelian, that is the incomplete dominance and codominance and pleiotropy. So incomplete dominance and codominance are basically intragenic interactions. Intragenic matlab within the allele, ki either it will be incomplete or if both the traits expresses itself, that is in the case of ABO blood group that we have discussed, to usko hum bolte hain codominance. And pleiotropy is when one gene governs or controls multiple characters. Okay, welcome on board Vikas. And before we move into the topic, I would like to discuss this question from the class practice pack which you get at the end of the class. Like this was given at the end of the previous class. So this is question number 5 from the previous CPP. So the question was, blue eye color is recessive to brown eye color. A brown eyed man whose mother was blue eyed marries a blue eyed woman. Their children will be A, both blue eyed and brown eyed in the ratio 1:1, B, all brown eyed, C, all blue eyed, and D, blue eyed and brown eyed in the ratio 3:1. So what will be the answer? Meanwhile I'm discussing, you can, if you know the answer you can type just A, B, C or D. So here you look into this, blue eye color is recessive to brown. So first thing which in any of these kind of a question you need to figure out which is dominant and which is recessive. So brown is dominant over blue. Now the question says blue eye color is recessive. So a brown eyed man, a brown eyed man marries whose mother was blue eyed. So एक जनरेशन आगे की बात करें तो द मदर वॉज ब्लू. इन दिस केस समथिंग यू नीड टू इन्फर, हर वक्त पनेट स्क्वायर बनाने की जरूरत नहीं है, सिंपली ओके. अनन्या एंड विकास से इट्स ए ए, सो लेट्स सी वॉट एग्जैक्टली. सो वेन इट सेज इट इज हिज मदर वॉज होमोजाइगस रेसेसिव, थिंक इन दैट टर्म. सो वेन एवर देर इज रेसेसिव पेरेंट, होमोजाइगस रेसेसिव, दैट मीन्स द चिल्ड्रेन इफ इट इज एक्सप्रेसिंग द डोमिनेंट ट्रेट इट इज डेफिनेटली हेट्रोजाइगोटिक इन कंडीशन. सो दिस मैन इज हेट्रोजाइगोटिक फॉर ब्राउन आई कलर हुज मदर वॉज ब्लू आइड एंड देन ही मैरीज अ ब्लू आइड वुमेन ओनली. सो अगेन ब्लू आइड वुमेन, सो वॉट विल बी द रिजल्ट ऑफ दिस cross, simply that is their children will be, so this is heterozygotic getting married to homozygous recessive, this is nothing but test cross. Or test cross mein hum jante hain ratio kya hoga, 1:1, so both blue eyed and brown eyed in the ratio 1:1 is the correct answer. So A will be the correct answer, not B, C and D. Is that clear to all others who have not given a try to the question? Clear hai ki kaise ye answer A hoga aur ना कि बी सी और डी. इन टूडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द फाइनल लॉ, दैट इज द लॉ ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट असॉर्टमेंट, जिसके जो कि डाई हाइब्रिड क्रॉस की वजह से आया है. and then we will be discussing some more gene interactions like supplementary gene, complementary gene, lethal gene, epistasis. So these things we are going to discuss in today's class. So first thing, that is law of independent assortment. So the law of independent assortment was derived with the help of dihybrid cross. The dihybrid cross kis chidiya ka naam hai? So here dihybrid ka matlab hai ki we are selecting a plant for two different characters and rest characters we can consider they are same. In monohybrid we were considering only one character. Monohybrid mein hum ek hi character ko consider karte hain. Dihybrid mein hum do character ko consider kar sakte hain. So karte hain, not kar sakte hain. So in dihybrid, so this is a cross between round and yellow seed and wrinkled and green seed. So round and yellow are dominant over wrinkled and green. So this is your parental generation. A cross between them will give us pure heterozygote, but they are round and yellow. So this is our F1 generation. Now when we do selfing of F1, so jab hum selfing of F1 karenge to number, total number of gametes produce kitna hoga, that is 2 to the power n, n is equal to the number of heterozygous genes. Aur yahan pe number of heterozygous kitne hain, 1, that is R, capital R and small r, capital Y, small y, so 2. So 2 to the power 2, so that gives us the 4. Okay, so here, so we will get 4 different types of gamete. So 4 different types of gamete will be capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y and small r, small y. So if we quickly do the cross or do all the combination, Sarcheriteron, very good evening, and Peru, good evening, thank you very much for coming in. So Peru, Sarcheri, is this the first class for you? So here let's quickly complete the cross. So this will be capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. Here it will be both capital R, but one capital Y, one small y. Then, see, I'm doing this only for this time, the complete thing, so that it is very clear what exactly will be the, like how exactly we do the cross. Rest of, in rest of the questions, when we discuss, you have to do it on your own. Capital Y, small y, again capital R, small y, capital Y, small y, then we have capital R, capital Y, capital Y, capital R will come here, small r, capital Y, small y. So again small r is actually for wrinkled condition, and small y are for green condition. So here it will be R, R. Then we have capital R, capital Y, small y. We will look into the final results very soon what it will be. And then here it will be this condition. And the final is homozygous recessive. Chalo ye to ho gaya. Phatapat. Okay. Now here if we look into this, so we have 16 different combinations because it is 4 into 4 Punnett square. In this, if we look into this big triangle, only on the lines, the squares which are, or rectangles which are falling on this triangle line, so their condition is definitely capital R. Here it can be small r or small y or capital Y, and this is again, it can be anything. And the phenotypic condition for this will be round yellow. Okay. And if we look into the numbers, it will be 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So this is 9. Next is, so we will look for the parental condition. Round yellow and wrinkled green. If we see wrinkled green, we get only in this corner. So wrinkled green has to be pure recessive, and this is only one. Now from where the independent assortment law came is the rest of the parts. If we look here, this condition, round green. Round, green. Here also this is round, green. So, three of them. So, for them the condition is this capital R, and it can be capital R or small r. So, this is round, green is 3. Another type is wrinkled yellow. So, this is again 1, 2 and 3. Wrinkled yellow. So, in case of wrinkled yellow, the condition will be this. And again it is 3. So, 9:3:3:1 is the phenotypic ratio. Typical Mendelian dihybrid ratio is 9:3:3:1. 9:3:3:1. But law of independence assortment aya kaha se? Yes, Tanishka, the ratio is 9:3:3:1. So, law of independent assortment basically came from this 3-3. Because if you look into the parental condition or hybrid condition, yahan pe kya hai? We have either round yellow or wrinkled green. But these two are recombinants. Round can make seeds with green also, and then wrinkled can be yellow also. So, this states or this proves that there is when the gametes or when the gametes are formed, the genes separate without the dependence of the other. That means it is not necessary that yellow will always move with round or green color will always move with the wrinkled shape. During gamete formation, they move independent of each other, and that is why there are 4 possibilities of gamete, and that is the reason we got the recombinants. Agar dependency hota, so in that case only 2 types of gametes will be formed, capital R, capital Y. Dominance will move with dominance and recessive traits will move with recessive ones, that is small r and small y. Because the, in the final condition we got 2 recombinants, that is round and green and wrinkled and yellow. This proves that the alleles assort independently. Alleles kya hai? Independently assort karenge. Wo ek dusre pe dependent nahi hai. Dominant recessive ke saath bhi ja sakta hai aur recessive dominant ke saath bhi ja sakta hai. Is that clear? So, let's quickly see the statement of law of independent assortment. So, Mendel's law of independent assortment states that the alleles of 2 or more different genes get sorted into gametes independently of one another. Unme koi dependency nahi hai. In other words, the allele of gametes receives for one gene does not influence the allele received for the another gene. So, simple terms mein, if the example which we have taken, agar kisi gamete mein the gene for round is going, that is not going to influence the color, whether it is going to take the yellow color ka gene or green color ka gene. It has equal possibilities. It can go with the yellow color also, and it can go with the green color as well. Is that clear to everyone? What does law of independent assortment states? And if it is clear, so now on your screen will come the first question for the class, and be prepared for the question, and your time starts now. Probability of genotype capital T small r in F2 generation of a dihybrid cross is 1 by 16, 3 by 16, 9 by 16, 6 by 16. So, here it is saying dihybrid cross. So, this is for 2 genes, capital T. So, other one will be small t and capital R. So, so that means it is asking you, okay, this I will explain, let you people answer. I will give you the time to give the answer, and then I will say. And your time is up. What happened? No answer. So, look here. This is capital T, small r. And when it is saying dihybrid cross F2 generation, that means the cross was between double dihybrids. Okay, Vikas, Ananya, Sarchirai, everyone says B. Dekhte hain kya hota hai. So, this, the cross is between this कैपिटल टी स्मॉल टी कैपिटल आर स्मॉल आर इसके बीच में क्रॉस है. नाउ व्हेन दिस क्रॉस इज देयर यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट अ कंडीशन वेयर यू हैव कैपिटल टी एंड स्मॉल आर बोथ द थिंग्स आर देयर. सो इन दिस कंडीशन सी दिस इज अ रिकॉम्बिनेंट ऑफ दिस कैरेक्टर्स. तो रिकॉम्बिनेंट कब आएगा ये इस कंडीशन में भी सेम थिंग देगा बिकॉज दिस इज डोमिनेंट. सो दिस कैन नॉट बी. वेन वी विल लुक फीनोटिपिकली दिस और दिस बोथ ऑफ देम टूगेदर विल गिव 3/16 रेशियो. बट वेन वी कंसिडर ओनली द होमोजाइगस एंड रेसेसिव कंडीशन इन दैट केस इट इज गोइंग टू बी 1/16. ठीक है, तो इसके लिए पूरा पनेट स्क्वायर बनाने का जरूरत नहीं है. इफ यू नो इट इज 3/16 जस्ट लुक हियर. बी सेज 3/16 तो 3 कम्स वेन द कंडीशन इज दिस और दिस. इट कैन नॉट बी ओनली दिस. 9/16 इज यू हैव टू हैव कैपिटल आर एंड कैपिटल टी बोथ, देन ओनली इट विल बी देयर. 6/16 डजंट कम्स इन नॉर्मल मेंडेलियन क्रॉस. सो दी आंसर इज ए. तो वहां से भी आप कर सकते हो कि वहां पे एक ही आएगा, 3 इज देयर. सो दी आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन इज ए एंड नॉट बी और सी. इज दैट क्लियर टू एवरी वन? पेरू, सर्चराई, तनिष्का, विभा, अनन्या, विकास, द आंसर इज ए एंड नॉट बी. नाउ ऑन योर स्क्रीन दी नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर दी क्लास विल कम. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 एंड योर टाइम स्टार्ट्स नाउ. प्योर होमोजाइगस ऑफस्प्रिंग्स इन अ डाइहाइब्रिड क्रॉस इन द F2 जेनरेशन विल बी 1/2, 1/4, 1/8, 1/16. You have 22 seconds remaining. चलो चलो बताओ बताओ. ओके थैंक यू अनन्या. लास्ट 7 सेकेंड्स. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 एंड डन. सो प्योर होमोजाइगस ऑफस्प्रिंग. सो प्योर होमोजाइगस मीन्स प्योर होमोजाइगस डोमिनेंट भी हो सकता है एंड इट कैन बी प्योर होमोजाइगस रेसेसिव एज वेल. और प्योर होमोजाइगस द एग्जाम्पल विच आई हैव टेकन राउंड एंड येल्लो. तो प्योर होमोजाइगस का मतलब है फॉर डोमिनेंट दिस एंड फॉर रेसेसिव स्मॉल आर स्मॉल आर स्मॉल वाई स्मॉल वाई. ओके सो 2C 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 फाइन. दिस टाइम एवरी वन इज ऑन सी. सो लेट्स सी. सो हियर तो क्या है, प्योर डोमिनेंट भी एक ही आता है और प्योर रेसेसिव भी एक ही आता है. सो इट विल बी 2/16. सो 2/16 विल गेट रिड्यूस टू 1/8 एंड वेरी गुड द आंसर विल बी सी ओनली. सो पेरू, अनन्या, विकास, विभा, गुड गोइंग. एंड इफ यू हैव सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन दैट मीन्स यू हैव सम फेयर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द क्रॉस. Now let's discuss the previous class contest question. So in the previous class I have asked a red tomato plant is crossed with a yellow tomato plant and all the offsprings have red tomatoes. Which trait is dominant? Simple, red or yellow ko cross kar rahe hain aur sabke sab red ho gaye. So obviously red is dominant character. Okay, red we are crossing with yellow. This is simple monohybrid cross. So in F1 generation the color which comes that is the dominant and the first person to answer this correctly was Pushpal. So a big round of applause for Pushpal. Clap 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 and you will get your free atom session credited to your account by the end of this class. Tanishka for a 2 the answer was C and not B. Is that clear why the answer is C? So just in case you are interested in winning the today's contest questions on your screen, now will come the today's contest question and be the first person to answer it correctly in order to win this contest. And here is the question. Last 37 seconds. 17 seconds. Now the bill says X, subscription says Y. Last 3 seconds, 2, 1, and done. So the answer to the contest question I will give in the next class, and till then have patience. And the winner also will be announced in the next class only. Now we are into the supplementary genes, that is under gene interactions only, and this is going to be intergenic. The two different genes ke beech ka interaction hai. Co-dominance and incomplete dominance was intragenic gene interaction. Intragenic means within the genes, for the same gene the interaction showed different Mendelian ratios. So here the first thing is supplementary gene. So what is supplementary gene? Supplementary genes are two independent pairs, that means two different, that's why I said it is intergenic, two independent pairs of dominant genes which interact in such a way that one dominant gene will produce its effect whether the other is present or not, and the second dominant when added change the expression of the first one but only in presence of the first one. Okay, so in this case you can say that when the two come, so both the dominants, they have their own expressions. The best example for this is the chicken comb, the domestic chicken comb. So in that we have the different varieties. It can be pea or it can be rose. So these are different shapes of the chicken combs. So in this condition, if it is pea, so pea, it can be P for homozygous or heterozygous condition, and for rose it can be this, fine. But here we have to look for different conditions. So it was seen that when P and rose were crossed, so as per Mendelian genetics it should come as either P or rose, but there was altogether a different characteristic which came, that is the walnut. Okay, and the gene and the person, or in the chicken, not person, the chicken, where both the genes were for recessive, in that case the condition which was there, so in both recessive condition the comb type is different, that is single. Theek hai, and from where it came, when this walnut was self, so this is F1, so when F1 was self, the ratio was 9:3:3:1 only, but 9 were walnut, 3 were pea, 3 were rose, and 1 was single. Okay, so this is the difference between Mendelian ratio and in this ratio, because Mendel mein kya hai ki dominance trait was there, but here this is intergenic interaction and neither pea comes nor rose comes, the one which appears is walnut. So for walnut, all the genes which will have one capital P at least and one capital R, all those genotypes will give us walnut, whereas P will come only when the condition is recessive for rose, or rose will come only when the condition is pure recessive for P, and here you need only one dominant R, so that gives us rose, and in single you have both of them as recessive, fine. So this is how the supplementary gene works. Now we are into the next thing, that is the complementary gene interaction, and in complementary gene interaction the classical Mendelian ratio, that is 9:3:3:1 जो है वो क्या किस में कन्वर्ट हो जाता है 9:7 में, एंड हाउ दैट हैपेंस, द कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री जीन्स आर टू पेयर्स ऑफ नॉन एलिलिक डोमिनेंट जीन्स, दीज आर नॉन एलिलिक एंड डोमिनेंट आल्सो, प्रेजेंट ऑन सेपरेट जीन लोकाई, सो दिस इज प्रेजेंट ऑन सेपरेट, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज इंटरजेनिक, विच इंटरैक्ट टू प्रोड्यूस ओनली वन फीनोटाइपिक ट्रेट, बट नाइदर ऑफ देम इफ प्रेजेंट अलोन प्रोड्यूसेज द फीनोटाइपिक ट्रेट in the absence of other. So let us understand with the help of an example, and the example is of Lathyrus odoratus or the sweet pea. So Lathyrus odoratus kya hai, this is scientific name of sweet pea. So in sweet pea, we have varieties of white flower plants. So when this white flower plants were crossed, so when the cross was done between two white flower plants, the offsprings or the flower which was formed was purple. The white se purple aa gaya, ab kaise aa gaya? Now the question is, chalo dekhte hain what will happen. So purple was selfed. In this condition, what was seen was ki the ratio was changed to 9:7. 9 of them were purple and 7 were white. Okay. So from here we can see that this can be explained in terms that the two genes which are interacting, they are forming components which are responsible for a chain of reaction. So purple kya hai? This is a pigment, anthocyanin. Theek hai? So it is said that one gene which is responsible, suppose it's B gene. So the B gene is responsible for producing the raw material for the pigment. So B kya bana raha hai? Uska raw material bana raha hai. And C probably produces the enzyme which converts this raw material into the pigment. So definitely the plants where both the genes are present in their dominant condition, then only we can get the pigment. Agar gene B ka bhi product absent hai, to raw material hi nahi aayega, aur gene C ka product absent hai, to enzyme nahi hai. So dono hi condition mein purple pigment form nahi hoga, and because of which we are getting the condition 7. So in this case, all the conditions, suppose if we take it as B and C, so for capital B and capital C, all the conditions, and that comes to 9, this will be purple in color. But the conditions where any of these is recessive, okay, where any of these is recessive, in that condition it will be all white. So that is why when we do the cross, this is for 3, this is for 3, and this is for 1. So 3+3+1, that all counts to 7. So the ratio becomes 9:7. I hope this is clear. What is meant by simple? Are you talking about the chicken comb? It was not simple, single. Peru. So is this a clear complementary gene interaction? So the ratio is reduced down to 9:7, and this is again inter-allelic gene interaction. Now next one is epistasis or inhibiting gene. So epistasis is the interaction between non-allelic genes again and present on separate loci. So separate loci means two different. Suppose this is chromosome number 1. So one gene is present on this locus, other can be present here, or it can be present altogether on a different chromosome, chromosome number 2. So loci is actually the, or locus is the position of a gene on a chromosome. So different locus means different position, so they are non-allelic. So single pero in this case, it is not that single, double, triple. Single is a condition. So P, rose, single, walnut, these are different kinds of combs found in case of the chickens. So in case of pea, like you have a small one, rose ka thoda kya hai, protruded hota hai. So and it has more of papillae. Similarly, single is more crowned kind of. So these are different kinds of combs found in case of the chickens. So this single is not equal to single, double or triple. This is the shape we are referring to. Clear, Peru? So epistasis is the interaction between non-allelic genes, as I was saying, and in which one gene masks or inhibits or suppresses the expression of the other. So yahan pe kya hai, do gene hai, and if gene B is present, it is going to mask the expression of the gene A. So this is called epistasis. So the gene which is masking, suppose B is masking A, so this will be called as epistatic gene, which is causing the effect of epistasis, and A will be called as hypostatic जी द वन विच इज गेटिंग सरप्रेस्ड और द हूज एक्सप्रेशन इज गेटिंग सरप्रेस्ड दैट विल बी कॉल्ड एज हाइपोस्टैटिक. अगेन इन केस ऑफ एपिस्टासिस वी हैव टू डिफरेंट कंडीशंस. इट कैन बी डोमिनेंट एपिस्टासिस और इट कैन बी रेसेसिव एपिस्टासिस. सो डोमिनेंट एपिस्टासिस इज एक्सप्लेन विद द हेल्प ऑफ समर स्क्वैश. समर स्क्वैश में वी सी डोमिनेंट एपिस्टासिस एंड इन दैट केस द टिपिकल मेंडेलियन रेशियो विच इज 9:3:3:1 गेट्स चेंज टू 12:3:1. दैट मीन्स इवन इफ सिंगल डोमिनेंट एपिस्टैटिक इज प्रेजेंट इट्स गोइंग टू चेंज द एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ द अदर जीन एंड हेंस 9+3 बिकेम द 12:3:1. Then we have the recessive epistasis and in recessive epistasis we just have the ratio 9:3:4. So in this case in recessive condition the gene can mask the expression of the other. So recessive epistasis can be explained with the coat color in mice. Mice ka jo coat color hota hai usme hum recessive epistasis ko explain kar sakte hain. So in case of coat colors we have ग्रे ओके और अगौटी विच इज सेड ग्रे देन वी हैव ब्लैक एंड देन वी हैव एल्बिनो. अगौटी ब्लैक एंड देन वी हैव द एल्बिनो व्हाइट कंप्लीटली. सो इन दिस कंडीशन इन दिस केस वेर एवर वी हैव बोथ द जीन्स ओके दिस इज अगौटी सो दैट इज 9. 3 कम्स when the condition is albino is just the condition where you have the B but you do not have A. A is recessive. So A is actually in recessive condition it is masking the B. Black ko wo mask kar de raha hai because it is not along the pigment formation. So wo albino ho jata hai and rest of the condition where you have A ka agar ek bhi hai so it doesn't matter what is present here that is going to be sorry albino will be 4 and black will be 3. Is that clear? And black is a condition where this is recessive. B will be recessive. So B and A both dominant if it is present that is 9. That is fine with Mendel's experiments and that's going to be agouti. But for black you need A and black needs to be in so gene B needs to be in its recessive state. Now the next thing which was there, so here you can have this condition or it can be this also. So wherever you have small a and small a, so this A was required for pigment formation which is not there and that is why the final ratio becomes 4:3:1 because in 4 of them you will have recessive condition for A and hence the for recessive epistasis the रेशियो फीनोटाइपिक रेशियो क्या हो जाता है 9:3:4. द नेक्स्ट जीन इंटरैक्शन इज लीथल जीन. सो एज द नेम इटसेल्फ सजेस्ट इट इज गोइंग इट इज और इट पुट्स क्वेश्चन मार्क ऑन द वायबिलिटी ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिज्म. सो सर्टेन जीन्स आर नोन टू कंट्रोल सम फीनोटाइपिक ट्रेट एज वेल एज एन इफेक्ट द वाइटल वायबिलिटी ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिज्म. सो वायबिलिटी कैसे वो इफेक्ट करेगा वेन इट इज कंट्रोलिंग एनी इम्पॉर्टेंट बायोकेमिकल पाथवे. अगर कोई इम्पॉर्टेंट बायोकेमिकल पाथवे को वो जीन गवर्न कर रहा है एंड देन इन दैट केस इन एनी कंडीशन इफ दैट बायोकेमिकल पाथवे इज गेटिंग ब्लॉक सो दिस कैन बिकम लीथल टू द ऑर्गेनिज्म. सम अदर जीन्स हैव नो इफेक्ट ऑन द अपियरेंस लाइक फिनोटाइपिक तो नहीं होगा बट जीनोटिपिकली और इन साइड द ऑर्गेनिज्म दे कैन हैव इफेक्ट विच कैन पुट क्वेश्चन ऑन देयर वायबिलिटी. दीज टाइप ऑफ जीन्स आर कॉल्ड लीथल genes. Similarly there are duplicate genes also that one gene mimics the expression of the other. So there are two different genes but the function of both are same. A is producing something B bhi wahi kaam karega. So in that case the if it is going to be duplicate dominant there the ratio changes is to 15:1 because 9:3:3 sab mein ek 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 kuch to dominant hai. Only for pure recessive it will change otherwise for all it will express. So 15:1 for dominant duplicate. This is another gene interaction. Then for recessive duplicate, it will become 9:7. With this, the gene interaction is also over, and now we are going to start off again with the question answer segment. And on your screen will come question number 3 for the class, and your time starts now. In shorthorn cattle, genes for red and white coat color occur. Crosses between red, that is R1, R2, and white R2, R2, produces R1, R2, that is Ron. This is an example of, so here it should be one only. Okay, so cross between red, so that is pure recessive. Pure red and pure white. So, pure red or pure white ka cross hum kar rahe hain aur humko kya mil raha hai? Roan. So, what it is? Complementary epistasis, co-dominance, incomplete dominance. And your time is up and let's see. So, see here, complementary, as we have seen, both of them when gets combined, they are going to form altogether a different color. So here this cannot be a case of complementary. Again, epistasis mein one gene masks the expression of the other. So here we are not seeing masking. Ron ka matlab hai ki it's a mix of color. That means you will get both white and red. So when both white and red are coming, so that is an example of co-dominance. Theek hai? Ki dono ke dono express kar rahe hain. Hence the answer for this question is C and not B, because the answer for this question is co-dominance and not epistasis. Is that clear? Now on your screen will come question number 4, and here it is. 9:3:3:1 ratio is modified to 9:7 ratio due to complementary gene, epistatic gene, hypostatic gene, supplementary gene. 9:7 कहाँ पे हो जाता है? It's a simple question. And answer it like 3AB or 4AB, because अब अगर फिर से you are going to add A or B, that will become confusing for me to which question you are answering. So 9:3:3:1 ratio is modified to 9:7 ratio due to complementary gene, epistatic gene, hypostatic gene, supplementary gene. Okay, Peru says 4B. Let's see. The time is also up. So, 4 ka B. Epistasis mein we have two different ratios. 12:3:1, that is dominant epistasis. For recessive epistasis, you have 9:3:4. So, 9:7 kahan gaya? 9:7 is for complementary. Abhi ta jod jod se I have explained with Lathyrus odoratus. The complementary may, when they get added up, because they are controlling different reactions AB, so that becomes 9:7. Clear? The answer for 4 is A and not B. Sab log epistasis kyu bol rahe? Epistasis se bahut pyar hai kya? Epistasis. For previous question also the answer you have given is epistasis. Is that clear why it will be epistatic and not why it will be complementary and not epistatic gene? Now on your screen will come the last and final question for this class, and I expect correct answer from all of you. Agar nahi aate to koi baat nahi, I will give you the answer. So F2 hybrid ratio 9:3:4 is explained on the basis of A, epistatic gene, B, supplementary gene, C, allelic interaction, D, complementary gene interaction. 9:3:4 किस में मिलेगा? Epistatic, supplementary, allelic, complementary gene interaction. Just now I have said. Last 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and time is up. What happened now? You people are not answering. बुरा मान गए क्या? ओके, 5A Vikas is again with epistaxis, Ananya also epistaxis, and this time you are very correct. The answer is epistaxis gene, and in case of this 9:3:4 humko kaha milta hai in case of recessive epistaxis. Dominant epistaxis mein kya ho jata hai? 12:3:1. This is dominant epistaxis. So all of you are correct. Ananya, Peru, Tanishka, Vibha and Vikas. So you all have stood as per my expectations. I'm really happy. With this, let's quickly summarize what we have discussed in today's class. So we have discussed the law of independent assortment. Law of independent assortment is proven by A, that is the dihybrid cross of Mendel's expression, and this the proof for this is the appearance of recombinants. Recombinants ka aana in F2 generation proves law of independent assortment, that during the formation of gametes the allele separates without depending on each other. Then we have discussed gene interactions like supplementary gene, complementary gene, lethal genes, epistaxis. So whenever you are going for gene interactions, whether the earlier ones which we have seen, that is the codominance and incomplete dominance, what you should be knowing is very precisely what happens in that definition. What is the ratio change from Mendel's to the particular gene interaction, like complementary gene 9:7 ho jata hai. So this you need to remember along with the classical examples. Some of them I have discussed in today's class only. With this, we have come to an end of this class. So thank you very much for joining in, and if you have liked this video or liked this class and found it useful, then please do like the video and share it with your friends so that they can also be benefited. And along with so, and those who are watching this on YouTube, in case you want me to answer to your questions or you want to participate in the quiz so that I can take your name also, please do come on our web page. And now it is class practice pack time or CPP time, so you will get the 10 questions of to practice in the form of class practice packs, and these 10 questions are based on what we have discussed today, that is law of independent assortment and gene interactions, and you should solve, because you have seen just now I have discussed all the things, but the last three questions which I asked, in first two you were confused. So these are the topics where you know the things, but when you solve more questions your brain will fix the memory for it. And the CPP is unlocked for passport members. For non-passport users it is still locked. So to get an access to the CPP, please do subscribe to passport membership, which will not only give you the access to the class practice packs, but also access to the 24/7 one-on-one doubt solving sessions, access to practice questions and tests from best-selling books, and access to all videos classes covering the toughest concepts and problems. On this note, I take your leave. Good night, Shubh Ratri, Shabba Khair, and we will meet at same place, same time, but with a different topic. Till then, good night. But passport users, do not go anywhere. Start solving the questions right away. Good luck.